ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ನಮಸ್ಕಾರ. ವೆಲ್ಕಮ್ ಟು ದಿ ಎಲ್ ಎಮ್ ಎಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಡಿಪಾರ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಕೊಲೆಜಿಯೇಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಟೆಕ್ನಿಕಲ್ ಎಜುಕೇಷನ್. ಮೈಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ಅಶೋಕ ಡಿ ಎಲ್, ವರ್ಕಿಂಗ್ ಆಸ್ ಅ ಲೆಕ್ಚರರ್ ಇನ್ ಎನ್ ಸಿ ಡಿಪಾರ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್, ಗೌರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಪಾಲಿಟೆಕ್ನಿಕ್ ಕೂಡಲಿಗೆ. ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಸೆಷನ್ ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ದ ಡಿಸ್ಕಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಮದರ್ ಬೋರ್ಡ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕ್ ಸಿ ಡಿ. Okay, it is the experiment number 11 of electronic servicing lab. Okay, in this session we will discuss these concepts, that is the functions of the motherboard, what are the importance of motherboard, and what are the steps to install the device drivers, and how to update and remove the device drivers already been installed, and the some of the multiple choice questions which are related to the what are the portions covered in this session. Okay, first we will discuss the functions of the motherboard. Okay, as we all know, in a personal computer or in a the laptop, okay, in a computer, the motherboard which plays very important the role, okay, for the all the ALU operations. What are the ALU operations performed in any computer system? It can be or it will be done by the motherboard only. Okay, first the function of the motherboard, okay, that is which controls the flow of external data through the port, such as the USB and the IDE. That IDE is integrated the development, the environment, and this motherboard, it not only controls the flow of data, the external data, what are the devices, what are the external peripheral devices we might have connected, the printers, we might have connected some external the devices like USB or the joystick, scanner, okay, which controls all the external data which has connected to the USB and to the IDE. And it also, it not only controlling, and it also guides the data to the hard drive. That is the first function of the motherboard. Okay, that is the motherboard which controls the flow of external data through the ports, such as the USB and the IDE, and guides the data to the hard drive. Okay, this is the first function of the motherboard. And another one is to which holds the microprocessor data. That is in some of the personal computer or in any computer system, we might have the Intel processor, or in some of the system it might contain the AMD processor. Okay, that is also the function of the motherboard. The main that is the second point. This is the main function of the motherboard is to hold the microprocessor chip. That it holds the microprocessor chip. It might be the Intel, or it might be the AMD. Okay, these are the two the functions of the motherboard. Okay, that is the first. I will repeat it again. The two functions of the motherboard. The first function is to controlling the flow of external data through the ports, such as the USB and the IDE, and also guides the data to the hard drives. Okay, and the second function is to hold the microprocessor the data. Okay, that is Intel or AMD. Okay, these are the two functions of the motherboard. And next we will discuss what are the importance of motherboard. Okay, as I told earlier, the motherboard, it is the main board. Okay, it is also known as a motherboard, because what are the functions and what are the ALU the functions is it's done by the personal computer, is nothing but it's done by the motherboard only. Okay, that's why it is also known as the main board, and it is the central circuit hub. Okay, that allows all the connections between the components and the peripherals attached to the computer. Okay, as I told earlier in the previous slide, Okay, that is we are already discussed in the functions of the model. Okay, because without just just by having the motherboard, or just by having the monitor, or just by having the CPU, we can't do anything. In case if we are giving any input to the personal computer, we require some of the input device. In case if we are having some data, it has to be printed on a paper, or it has to be documented on some of the material. Okay, because of all these, to give the input and to take a printout, we need some of the peripheral devices. Okay, that's why we have to connect to give the input. We are already using the keyboard or a mouse. Okay, and to take a printout, just we can use a printer. Okay, and these are all the input and output devices. That is, what are the external devices are connected to the computer. It is nothing but these are all also called as a peripheral devices. Okay, this motherboard, which allows all the connections between all the components and peripherals which are attached to the computer. That is the first importance of a motherboard. And the second point in computing, a device driver is a computer program that operates or controls a particular type of device that is attached to a computer. In this way, just for example, in our personal computer, if we need a internet connection, okay, for that internet connection, we have to install the local area network drivers, that is the LAN drivers. In case if we want to take a printout, in my computer, I have connected a printer that is named by Canon, or that is another is Epson. Okay, there are so many the printers are available in the market. In case to the my computer, I have connected the Canon printer. To take a printout, I have to install a Canon device driver. Okay, that is the second point. Okay, the controls upon the device driver is a computer program that operates or controls a particular type of device that is attached to a computer. That is the second point. And the third point, a driver communicates with the device through the computer bus or a communications subsystem to which the hardware connects. Okay, just in every year, it's a bus means it is just a communication channel through which all the drivers are through which all the hardware, that is whatever we have connected, that is it might be keyboard, mouse, joystick, printer, scanner, whatever all the peripheral devices we have connected, it's all are communicated through a computer bus. Okay, that is the third point. And the fourth point, the main purpose of a device driver is to provide abstraction by acting as a translator between hardware device and the applications or operating systems that use it. That means, in case if I have connected a printer or if we have connected a keyboard, a mouse, okay, the device driver, it acts like a translator between the hardware device and the applications or operating system we have installed in our personal computer. It acts like it's a translator between the peripheral device, that is the hardware device, and the applications we have installed in a personal computer. And the next point, because of the diversity of modern hardware and operating systems, drivers operate in many different environments. Okay, drivers may interface with the printers, just as I told earlier, in a personal computer, just to give a input or just to take a output, just to take a printout, just we have to, or just to use the internet, we have to interface with the many hardware devices, that is the printers, video adapters, networkers, or in case if you want in nowadays in all the laptops are already has been installed with the it's a Windows 8 operating system or it's a Windows 10 operating system. In future it may come it's a Windows 11 or Windows 12. Okay, in all the operating system they are already built in with the all these applications. But in earlier just when we are when we are studying B, in that only the Windows XP operating system is available. In thus, in that Windows XP operating system, none of the drivers has been installed. Okay, none of the drivers has not been come up with the operating system. In that case of Windows XP operating system, we have installed all the sound, the device driver, or a network device drivers, or a for the some of the gaming application, just we have to install the some of the video adapters. Okay, all these are that is the point. That is the, because of the diversity of modern hardware and operating system, a drivers operate in a many different environments. Okay, the drivers may interface with the printers, video adapters, network cards, and some cards. Okay, these are the importances of the motherboard. Just I'll recall on all the points in a brief. That motherboard, okay, the first point, first importance of the motherboard, just as I said earlier, it is also known as the main board. That it is the central circuit hub which allows the connection between all the components and all the peripherals which are attached to the computer. And in a computing, it just does the device driver, it just operates or which controls a type of device that is attached to a computer. And this driver communicates with that device through a some bus, that is through a one communication channel. Okay. And the main purpose of the device driver is to, it acts like a translator between the a hardware device and the applications or operating systems that use it. And the last point, and because of the diversity of modern hardware and operating system, the drivers operate in a many different environments. Okay, drivers may interface with the printers, video adapters, network cards, sound cards. Okay. These are all the importance of motherboard. Okay, and next we'll move to the next point. That is just in the last two slides, we have briefly discussed what are the functions of motherboard and what are the importance of motherboard. Next, we will discuss what are the steps to install the device drive. Okay, the first step is to, in every personal computer or in every laptop, whatever, in every personal computer, they will provide a one CD. That is, they will usually in nowadays they are providing the three or more CDs. That is, they are giving one backup CD and one is the built-in. Might be in my system, it's a Windows 10 operating system. They will give one Windows 10 Pro operating system CD and one backup CD, and there is a one more CD, that is the device driver CD, that is the motherboard device driver CD. The first step, we have to insert that CD or DVD drive to the our machine. That is, machine is nothing but here it is to our computer. Okay, we have to insert a device driver CD to the DVD drive. It is a CD or DVD drive. That is the first step. And in the second step, whenever after inserting that motherboard CD to the DVD drive, okay, an installation program will be launched, which will initiate the process. Okay, simply follow the prompts that will appear on the screen to complete the setting up of the appropriate device driver. The installation program will also terminate automatically once the process is completed. Okay, that is the second step. And the third step, in the third step, in the earlier case, what I said, if we are having the motherboard CD, by using CD also we can install the device drivers. And the third step, just I'm briefing, and other than CD, we can also install the device drivers by using flash drives, that is by using USB. Okay, that is the third step. The device drivers may also be distributed using the removable storage like flash drives. These types usually represent driver updates to take advantage of functions in a newer operating system platform. Okay, insert the flash drive in the appropriate port. Okay, just after inserting the CD or after inserting a USB, just you have to wait for the that is the fourth step. You have to wait for the operating system to recognize the removable storage media. The process may start immediately, the installation process. If the and the next step, if the installation does not begin automatically, simply open the Explorer program and navigate to the appropriate drive. Locate the executable file which will launch the device driver application. And in the next step, step number 6, make sure to choose the correct version which corresponds to your operating system. For example, just as I said earlier, in nowadays all our we are using it's a Windows 7, Windows 8 or Windows 10 or Windows 10 Pro. But earlier it's a Windows XP, Windows Vista, Windows 7. There are so many operating systems. For every device in every the motherboard CD, they are providing a device drivers to the all the earlier version of the operating system. They might also provide the Windows XP drivers, Windows Vista drivers, Windows 7, Windows 8 or Windows 10 drivers also. Just you have to choose the correct version which corresponds to your operating system. That is the step number 6. The step number 7, in all device driver installation procedures, make sure to scan the files with your production software before beginning the process. Because in every personal computer, for the production of the viruses, like just we have to install the antivirus software. By using that antivirus software, just we have to scan all the files, okay, which are stored in that USB or in the CD, okay. And once the device driver has been successfully installed into the system, reboot the machine to ensure all the changes are reflected in the operating system. And after installation of all the device drivers, okay, after installation of all the video drivers or audio drivers or LAN drivers which are corresponds to your operating system, you have to reboot the machine and you have to reboot the personal computer to changes to be affected. Okay, in the last the slide, this we have discussed what are the steps to install the device drivers. But next we will discuss how to update the device drivers is already been installed, or how to remove the device drivers it's already been installed on our personal computer. First we will discuss to update a device driver. Okay, and that to update a device driver, it's already been installed in my system. Already I have installed a audio driver or LAN driver. But after installation of the device drivers, in future it may come up with the some of the updates. In that case, we have to update the device drivers it's already been installed in my personal computer. In that moment, how to update the device drivers? For this process, you have to open the device manager in your personal computer. To open a device manager in a Windows 10 or in a Windows 8 operating system, just by search the device manager, you will get you can directly open the device manager. But in the Windows 7, it's the simple way to open the device manager. It's by typing devmgmt.msc in the run dialog box. Okay, just by typing this one, you can directly open the device manager. Just I will show in my the Windows 10 operating system. Okay, in this it's a Windows 10 operating system. It's a built in my personal computer. Okay, you can directly search the device manager here. You can directly search the device manager here. Okay, after, okay, this is the device manager. In some of the computer, in some of the operating system, you can't directly find the device manager. In that process, you have to open the this one. Okay, just we have to type the DEVMGMT. That is the device management. Okay, DEVMGMT.MSC in run dialog box. And in run also, you can find it here. Okay, there is a run button. And in this here, you can type here. You can type DEVMGMT.MSC. Okay, by typing the DEVMGMT.MSC, we will get this one. We will get the device manager. Okay, just after opening the device manager, okay, just next step is to right click the desired device and select properties. Okay, just I will open the device manager. Okay, these are all the device drivers is already been installed in my personal computer. Okay, here there is a audio input and outputs. There are the drivers, and this is the Bluetooth drivers, and this is the it's the built-in camera driver, and here in the network, it's related to the it's the internet connection. Okay, there is the network drivers. It's already been installed my the personal computer. Just by right clicking the all the or just by yeah by click here. You can get what are the device drivers. It's already been installed. Okay, and here after this, to update the device driver button, okay, to update the device drivers, just see here, there is the Realtek. Okay, that is it's a LAN driver. It's already been installed on my personal computer. To update this driver, just by right clicking this one, you will get there is a update driver. Okay, and after this update, after by clicking the update driver, there are two options are available here. That is a search automatically for drivers, and there is a the another option that is the drivers browse my computer for drivers. In case if you are having a motherboard CD, and just for the installation of this device drivers, already I told we have already inserted the device driver CD and browse my computer for drivers. And here just you have to share the location. Okay, in this case, just you have to go to the PC. And in this PC, just you will having that the device driver. Okay, that the DVD drive will show. In case if you are after inserting the motherboard CD to the device driver, you have to select the device driver. Okay, just by clicking OK, you will install or just you are updating the drivers. Okay, this is to update the device driver. Just I will recall once again, to update the device driver, just as I said earlier, in the Windows 10 operating system or in the Windows 8 operating system, just by typing the device manager name itself in the search button, you will directly open the device manager. In case if you are unable to open the device manager by typing it in the search button, you can directly open it in run dialog box also. In the run dialog box, you have to type devmgmt.msc. And after opening the device manager, just this is the window is opened. Okay, this is the window is open. It looks like this, and it shows all the drivers already installed or to be installed in my personal computer. And just you have to search in case I want to update the LAN drivers. Okay, in that case, you have to click here. It's a network adapter, and choose anyone. This is the Realtek, or there is another one. There is the Bluetooth device. It is also its commander. It's a network adapter. So in case if I want to update the Realtek, just right click here and update driver, and you can browse my computer for drivers. You can choose this one and browse to the CD, motherboard CD. Okay. And after this, next, the second one, that is okay. And in the next one, okay, this is the steps to update the device driver. Okay, and next, okay, that is earlier whatever we have discussed, that is to update the driver tab, update the device driver. So next we will discuss about the to remove the device drivers. Okay, in the earlier slide, it's the same procedure. Just we have to follow the same procedures whatever we have discussed in the earlier slide. Okay, here also to remove the device driver, we have to start the device manager by typing as a dev.mgmt.ms in the run dialog box, or in a my Windows 10 operating system or Windows 8 operating system, we can directly open the device manager just by typing here. Okay, there is the device manager, it's shown here. By click on the device manager, it will open. Okay, this is the device manager. It's already it's open in the system. Okay, it looks like in the same way. And after opening the device manager, just we have to select the driver. What are the unwanted drivers? It's already being installed on our computer. Just we want to remove all those the installed drivers. Okay, in this case, just we have to. In case if I want to remove this Realtek network driver, just by right clicking here, you can click the it's uninstall the device. Okay, and after the clicking this one, you can click just by clicking the uninstall this the device drivers, it will be uninstalled or it will be removed from your personal computer. This is the way. The remove the drivers of device drivers, it's already been installed in our personal computer. Okay, this is the way we can update the drivers, or we can remove the device drivers just by opening the device manager. In the device manager, okay, in this device manager, all the drivers it's been showing here, it's already the drivers installed in my the computer. In case if I want to update the device drivers, you can right click the you can right click here, and just by clicking the right click here, you can update the drivers. And to if you want to remove the driver, just by clicking the uninstall device, you can remove the driver. Okay, this is the way we are updating we are uninstalling, that is we are removing the device drivers. Okay, this is the session. Okay, in this session, okay, this is the session, it's regarding the device drivers installation and what are the importance and what are the functions of motherboard and how to update the device drivers, or how to update the how to remove the device drivers or how to update the device drivers. Okay, and just we will glance some of the MCQ questions. Okay, that is the multiple the choice questions. Okay, that's the first question. Now it's already what are the portions covered in this session? It's all these the some of the multiple choice questions which are related to the what are the portions covered in this session. Okay, there is the first question. The dashboard transmits the data in group of bits is faster than a serial port and is generally used to connect a printer. Okay, there are four options they are giving. The first option is Ethernet. The second option is a peripheral. Third option is a parallel. And the fourth option is connectivity. Okay, that is the first question. Okay, that is the dash port. Okay, either it is an Ethernet port or either it is a is it a peripheral port or is it a parallel port or is it a connectivity port? Okay, the answer is a parallel port. Okay, the parallel port transmits a data in group of bits is faster than a serial port and is generally used to connect a printer. Okay, in the serial port, the data is transmitted in a bit by bit. Okay, but in a parallel port, we can transmit all the bits at a time. That's why the parallel port transmits a data in a group of bits faster than a serial port. Okay, the answer is parallel port. Answer is C, parallel. The next question, USB ports are fast replacing traditional dash and dash ports because of their ability to transfer data quickly. The option A, video and audio ports. Option B, parallel and serial ports. Option C, it's a typo mistake. It's option C, actually that is C, it is not B. Ethernet speaker ports and option D monitor modem ports. I will repeat the question once again. USB ports are fast replacing traditional, that is earlier. Okay, before the USB ports, earlier what are the ports we are using? Okay, to transfer data quickly. Okay, earlier we are using parallel and the serial ports. Earlier, just as we know, for keyboard and mouse, we have connected, we are connecting those two, keyboard and mouse, to the PS2 port. Okay, that is a it's a parallel and serial port. In nowadays, we are using USB mouse and USB keyboard. Okay, but earlier we are using is a parallel and the serial. Okay, the answer is B. And in the parallel and compared to the serial, the parallel port is faster, but USB port, which is a faster than these two, it's a parallel and the serial port. So the answer is B, parallel and serial port. I will repeat, I will complete the question. Once again, with the answer, USB ports are fast replacing traditional parallel and serial ports because of their ability to transfer data quickly. So the answer is B, parallel and serial. Next, we will move to the next question. The dash port resembles a standard phone jack. I will repeat the question once again. The dashboard resembles a standard phone jack. Option A, firewire, option B modem, option C serial, option D peripheral. So the answer is modem. Thus I will complete the question with the answer. The modem port resembles a standard phone jack. So the answer is B. Next we will move to the next question. Dash is referred to as primary storage. I will repeat the question once again. Dash is referred to as primary storage. The option A RAM, option B ROM, option C the CPU, option D the system unit. Okay, the answer is option A, that is RAM. I will complete the question with the answer. RAM is referred to as primary storage because that ROM, that hard disk we have connected, it is a secondary storage device. The primary storage device is RAM, that is random access memory. Next question. Dash is a series of small cards that plug into slots on the motherboard. I will repeat the question once again. Dash is a series of small cards that plug into slots on the motherboard. Option A the CPU, option B RAM, option C ROM, option D the system unit. So the answer is B, RAM, that is random access memory. So I will repeat the question or the complete the question with the answer. RAM is a series of small cards that plug into slots on the motherboard. So the option the answer is B, option B, RAM. Okay. The next question. Flash drives are plugged into a dash port. Actually, plug into a dash. To which port the flash drives are plugging? Okay. The option A USB port, option B serial port, option C expansion slot, option D drive bay. The answer is option A, USB port. So usually the flash drives are plugged into a USB port. Okay. So the answer is A, option A, USB port. Next question. Dash plug into the expansion slots on the motherboard. I will repeat the question once again. Dash plug into the expansion slots on the motherboard. Option A ports, option B expansion boards, option C USB devices, option D drive bays. The answer is expansion boards. So usually the expansion boards which are plugged into the expansion slots on the motherboard. So the answer is expansion boards. Next we'll move to the next question. Which type of software are device drivers? Which type of software are device drivers? Option application software, option B यूटिलिटी सॉफ्टवेयर, ऑप्शन सी सिस्टम सॉफ्टवेयर, ऑप्शन डी एक्सपेंशन सॉफ्टवेयर। एंड आउट ऑफ ऑल दीज फोर सॉफ्टवेयर विच टाइप ऑफ सॉफ्टवेयर आर डिवाइस ड्राइवर्स, दैट इज द क्वेश्चन। एंड आंसर इज सी द सिस्टम सॉफ्टवेयर। ओके, द डिवाइस ड्राइवर्स आर ऑफ ए सिस्टम सॉफ्टवेयर पैक। नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, डिस्क ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम, दैट इज अ डॉस। ओके, डॉस वॉज डिजाइन टू वर्क विथ डैश इनपुट डिवाइस। I'll repeat the question once again. Disk operating system DOS was designed to work with dash input device. Option A mouse, option B joystick, option C keyboard, option D Xbox. So the answer is C, keyboard. Okay, usually the DOS, that is, it's a type of operating system, it's a disk operating system, was designed to work with keyboard input device. So the answer is C, keyboard. Next question, the backbone of a computer is dash. I will repeat the question once again. The backbone of a computer is dash. Option A, the CPU. Option B, motherboard. Option C, HDD, that is hard disk drive. Option D, the monitor. So, the answer is B, motherboard. We have discussed earlier in this session, we have already discussed the functions and what are the functions and what are the importance of motherboard. In that case, the motherboard is the backbone of a computer. So the answer is B. Okay, this is the experiment number 11 in part A of the electronic servicing lab. Okay, this is our team. Okay, this is our LMS team, and I thank all of our teammates and everyone who has supported to make this video and make this content. Thank you.